Hey y'all, Phil here. I tried to stop and metal detect at that little beach that I metal detected last time in Destin, the one that had all the dead stinky fish in the beach. But I pulled in there and that parking lot was just jam-packed full. I could not find a place to park. There was a spot in some soft sand, but I did not want to pull into that. I didn't want to get stuck. So anyway, I left. I came a little bit further down the road, and I've got a treat for you. That is, if you like Air Force. I'm at the Air Force Museum on Eglin Air Force Base, and so we're going to walk around and look at some of the displays. That is the Blackbird SR-71. They are not used anymore because I know the Air Force has got a new one. But that's what that one is. Here is a B-52. This was the workhorse for many, many, many years as far as a bomber goes. Flew all over the world, stationed all across the United States. These static displays set outside the Air Force Armament Museum here at Eglin. Of course, this in front of us, the Moab, mother of all bombs. This was made for Iraq and Afghanistan. This is basically the bunker buster. Hit bunkers and go all the way through the ground and explode down inside. Little light observation forward spotter plane there. This is a MiG-21 fish bird, it says. This is actually a Russian fighter. F-4 over here, you've seen those like at the Navy Museum and stuff. This is a B-47 Stratajet. That's what that is. F-104 Starfighter. And then a JF-101B Voodoo. So we got us an F-100 Super Saber. F89 Scorpion. And this one is the F86, like the Korean War model, early Vietnam. F84 Thunder Streak. CGM 13B Mace Missile. And of course, T-33. This is when I was a plane captain on when I was in the Navy. Over in the Subic Bay, Philippines. The Navy had some of those training birds. And the Tomahawk missile there. Another RF-4 reconnaissance. This is reconnaissance ones. There are cameras and stuff in it for taking pictures. Navy had some of those too. And of course, I don't know what all these planes are. I'm reading the little placards as I walk by. The F-111. White missile things or sidewinders. F-15 Eagle. F-16. The A-10 Warthog. Oh, they're calling this an A-10A Thunderbolt. Look at that Gatling gun right there in the nose for ground close ground support. See one of these things come rolling in hot. They wipe everything out. It's kind of a blackbird, obviously painted black for high altitude reconnaissance. Maybe this placard will say. B-57 Canberra, first blown in Britain in 1949. And a B-17 Flying Fortress, workhorse of World War II right here. Yes, sir. A lot of hours flown in World War II on that. A lot of bombing. B-17. 25, April of 1942. That's a huge helicopter. He even set it for in-flight refueling. MH-53. Yeah, search and rescue, long range. Okay. Sleek, fast. Kept it, U.S. kept that a secret for a long, long time. SR-71 Blackbird. Speed, 2,500 miles an hour, Mach 3 plus, 3 plus. Range, 3,682 miles without refueling. No armament, ceilings 85,000 feet plus. This was the spy bird. I'm sure it flew many hours over Russia and Northern Hemisphere, Southern Hemisphere. And then back to the B-52. Okay, we come inside to the Armament Museum. Just gonna do a quick walkthrough, kind of like I did with Pensacola. There's so much in here to see, I can't really stop and talk about everything that's in here. Bombs that thing can carry, not all at once, of course, different times, different armament setups. A couple drones up there in the ceiling. Browning 1918 automatic rifle. It's a huge sucker. Oh, we got him in a vault locked up at night. Cannon. Loss. RPG. Lower left. There's rifles and shotguns. Thompson right there, container, M18, M16, the top. M1 carbine up on top there. It's the one my dad brought home from the war and the one I wanted, but somehow it disappeared after he died. I don't know who ended up with it. Anti-tank rifle. .30 millimeter Avenger cannon. No flintlocks up there in the top. Homemade one in the top there. Different machine guns. I don't know if all this stuff's interesting to you guys, but sure it is for some. Millimeter cannon off the Warthog, M10 says. You got another blue canoe over there. Spent a few hours in that. Take a quick jaunt upstairs, see if they...
Just different displays with the placards and stuff. Models. It might be too dark in here to see, but we'll see when I try editing it. Still going? Yep. Battery's getting low though, it's flashing. The cluster bomb and gets down, opens up, and then all the little bomblet munitions inside come out, and they're like little hand grenades, just explode all over. see if there's enough light here due to that. Okay, I'm gonna call this it for inside. There's a lot of stuff. It takes you, you know, several hours to just walk slowly and look at every little placard and every scene and all that kind of stuff, but I'm gonna call it for now. So until later, fill out.